Hi there and welcome to Jardine Motors Group, and here it is, the brand new BMW 3 Series Touring facelift. It's the first one I've seen and it's actually arrived before the saloon, so we've got a separate video today for you just for the touring. It looks beautiful in this Brooklyn grey that you can see. This is a new colour for this model, and as you can see, an extensive facelift. There's so much to talk about here today. So that's what we're going to do in this video. If you have any questions, feel free to get in contact with a member of staff from Jardine BMW, and please make sure you subscribe to our channel. So we start off with the front. Extensive changes located at the front here. We have a redesigned front apron, and as we look all the way around, there is nothing that's shared from that previous generation. We're still in that seventh generation, but it's just that this is a newer version, a facelift. We also call it the life cycle impulse. As we move up to the top here, there's also big changes as well. We have a redesigned kidney grille located just here. And as this car is fitted with the M-Sport Pro package, that actually changes this completely to a high gloss black. In the same way that this car also has fitted with it the visibility package, which then allows these headlights to be the full adaptive LED with the blue accents. These are fantastic technology if you haven't already experienced them. They allow you to see up to 500 to 600 meters in darkness, and it uses technology located up here by the windscreen to block out certain vehicles at nighttime to allow the utmost safety but the most distance. Very, very clever technology. Now we know that the front has got some extensive changes, let's now have a look at the back. Moving to the back, as you can see, that rear apron has a design difference again, and it features this kind of splitter-like effect located at the bottom here. It looks absolutely wonderful, and it contrasts so nicely with that Brooklyn grey. I've reviewed a couple of cars now in Brooklyn grey, and it is a beautiful colour, a nice addition to this range. As we are at the back, I want to talk about the boot. Firstly, we have this area we can lift up just here, a nice glass panel. That's not a change to the previous model. That's always been a really popular thing, but it's nice to just pop some things in the boot if you wish to do so. But then I have the electronic tailgate located as standard and reversing camera as standard, and the space in this car is phenomenal. Absolutely amazing levels of space in this car, which hasn't changed over the previous model, but really worth mentioning if you haven't heard it before. We now understand model information and engine information, which is a very large category for this car, so bear with me, but also it is subject to change as we may bring out further engines after this filming. When it comes to understanding the trim levels of this car, it starts Sport. We then have the M Sport model, which is what this is, and then M Performance model, which is for those range-topping higher engines that just sit above the M Sport model. It then comes to the engines themselves. We'll start off with the petrol engines. We have a 320i, which is a 2-litre four-cylinder engine with 184 horsepower, a 330i, same engine as the 320i, so 2-litre four-cylinder, but with 258 horsepower. We then have the range-topping M340i, a 3-litre six-cylinder engine with 374 horsepower. We move on to the diesel engines now. We have a 320D, which is available either as rear-wheel drive or four-wheel drive, which is 190 horsepower from a 2-litre four-cylinder engine. And then we have the range-topping diesel, the M340D X-Drive. That is a 3-litre six-cylinder engine with 340 horsepower. Now, lastly, all of those diesel engines and the range-topping M340i will feature mild hybrid technology. And if you haven't heard of that before, that's technology which allows a 48-volt battery inside here to take some of the load off of the engine to allow it to drive more efficiently as you're driving. So if you haven't heard of it before, it's basically making this vehicle much more efficient if you go with a mild hybrid technology engine. And finally, well, Generation 4 hybrid technology is still around with this car. It was really impressive when we saw it come out on the 3 Series Touring and Saloon first time round, but we still can get that 330e. Now, it comes either as rear-wheel drive or as X-Drive, four-wheel drive, and it's up to 41 miles of electric on the 330e, coming from a 2-litre petrol engine. And then we also have up to 37 miles of electric on the four-wheel drive version, coming from a 2-litre engine as well. Lots of information there, but as you can hear, lots and lots to choose from. And now we move on to the interior of this car, and this is where you're going to see a major change as part of the facelift. We previously had some very good technology, the ID7 operating system, or Operating System 7 as it's also known. They've now stuck ID8 in here, which is a really big shouting point for BMW, and you receive this as standard. That's a really big deal. So this technology is amazing. You may have seen it in some of BMW's electrified vehicles over the last year or so. It is a really impressive piece of technology. If I was to just tap the map as an example, we get a 14.9-inch screen and around 13-inch screen located here with lots of information at our fingertips. It is a fantastic system to use. Lots of connectivity as well. Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, all of those features as you would expect. But when it comes also to this area down here, this has seen a slight change as well. We still have a controller to control these features, which customers do like, of course. But we have an area located here that's slightly changed for the gear selector. It's become very minimalistic. And actually, I quite like that. It gives you a bit more space down here. We still have this area here with, of course, our cup holders, a USB, 12-volt socket connection, and some more space in the front here. But all in all, it is still a wonderful, wonderful place to be. And that sums up this video. We have some extensive changes and a very, very special vehicle. Nice and futuristic with how it looks, but also nice and futuristic with technology as well. If you have any questions, feel free to get in contact with a member of staff at Jardine BMW, and please make sure you subscribe to our channel. Thank you.